Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. So there's a lot of ABAP news this week. Let's start with the SAP BTP ABAP Environment 2208 release. This week, Florian Wall posted his blog post, which gives us a rundown of all the new features delivered in 2208. One of the major highlights for me is the support for native consumption and exposure of business events and integration with the SAP Event Mesh. Another cool feature is around wrap extensibility, where a developer might want to adapt an existing wrap application to their specific requirements. The wrap framework now supports extensibility on different levels in the data model, including extensions for database tables, CDS views, behavior definitions, and service definitions. Another super useful feature in 2208 is around support for OData streams, allowing the developer to integrate LOBs in the application. So for example, it's now possible to handle binary or text files in your wrap applications. So there is a ton more in here, guys. Way too much for me to mention here. So if you want the full story, check out Florian's blog post today. Also wanted to mention that there is an upcoming SAP community call happening on September 26th at 11 a.m. Eastern time on SAP S/4HANA Cloud ABAP environment, also known as Embedded Steampunk. We will have Mohan Kumar Jayaram and Carl Kessler talk to us about how Embedded Steampunk supports the development of tightly coupled extensions that run directly on the S/4HANA Cloud technology stack. For more information, check out the events page in the SAP community group.
As you may have heard, SAP Code Jams are back, and we're all very excited to restart this program of hands-on, in-person events. There's a couple of new things to know about. First of all, we've got a new set of categories, and we're starting with ABAP, UI5, and BTP. And second, we're organizing everything in the new SAP events area on the community platform. We've also got discussion groups there for the SAP CoJams as well. We've already held three CoJam events this year in Newtown Square, in Waldorf, and in Melbourne. And we wanted to let you know about a couple of other ones that are coming up soon. First, on Friday the 16th of September in Warsaw, Poland, we have an SAP CoJam event in the UI5 category, SAP UI5 for beginners. And then a little bit later in September, on Friday the 23rd, the day before the SAP Inside Track Belgium event on the Saturday, we have a CoJam in the BTP category, hands-on with the BTP CLI and APIs. So head on over to the SAP CoJam area in our SAP Events community platform and check out all the details.
Hola, SAP developers. The SAP BTP security recommendations were recently published. The website contains security recommendations for identity authentication, the destination service, the credential store, and cloud connector. There are multiple recommendations for each service. Each recommendation includes details on the default and recommended settings, as well as detailed instructions on how to achieve the recommended state. Keep an eye on this page as additional services will be added soon. The SAP Private Link service helps establish a private connection between several SAP BTP services and selected services in your own cloud infrastructure provider accounts, which means that by using SAP Private Link service, the traffic between the services doesn't go through the internet, but through the cloud infrastructure provider's network. Harutyun shows us two use cases for SAP Private Link connectivity in his blog post. He covers how we can use the SAP application router as a proxy to extend our hybrid integration scenarios and enable communication between services like SAP Cloud Integration or SAP Launchpad to an SAP S/4HANA system running on Microsoft Azure. All this through a private network by using the SAP Private Link service. You can find the links in the description below.
Hi everyone. The SAP App Router is now publicly available as a Docker image on Docker Hub. This makes the use of the standalone app router on the SAP Business Technology Platform Kima environment a lot easier, as you no longer have to build or maintain your own Docker image. Check out Gaurav's blog post for more details and a sample application.